Okay, we go. Hey, sir. Sorry for the delay. So you going to a hotel in Pala? Yeah, another place. It's lucky for you, Pala has only one hotel still working. See that plane? You won't see any more very soon. It's probably the last one out of this country. Full of rich people. Only money and connections can get you up. Bloody idiot. Nobody follows the rules anymore. I told him the plane's gone, but they don't believe me. Everyone thinks the big planes are coming back. Who can say anymore? Hey, look at that. I see something. You do so much with fire. It smells like a virus, I think. My brother, he's such a beautiful bungalow with a cricket. Hey, a rich man. A brush fire destroyed everything, and now he left the country. Yeah, he'll be back.
This is Liberation Radio, speaking the truth for the truth seekers. And the truth is that your country needs you. Beware the evil APR Scorch. A plague has gripped our beauty.
They're not fans of the DJ. Maybe his music choices, who knows?
What about some smelly checkpoint is all, ne?
I mean, I'm Nimzana.
Where are you headed?
My passenger, driving him to the hotel in town.
You come from the airport?
Yes, sir, the airport. Gentlemen, you are posted here all day, ne? On my way back, I grab some cold beer. You drink beer, ne?
Yep, beer. We drink beer. Hurry up then. Move along.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. I'll see you soon, sir. Come into our country, steal everything, and they leave us nothing. A lot of troops nowadays. It's okay, they keep to themselves most of the time. Don't let this concern you, just boys letting off steam, right? You remember how you.
Come on.
stain. Fools and cab drivers. Are you okay? You don't look so good. You tired? Long flight.
Target's presence in the state continues to be a destabilizing influence. He's largely responsible for the recent influx of weapons into the country and clear violation of the Joint Signatory Framework. His reputation as a dangerous arms dealer is well deserved. Orders are to terminate. Well, that didn't work out the way they planned. I'm still breathing and you're the one with malaria. You can tell them you tried, but that means fuck all, doesn't it? You're fired. You know it and so do I. You had your shot, but now it's over. And since men like you only work for money, you're no longer my problem. You'll have to find something else to do with yourself now. What your old clients don't seem to understand is that they can't kill me. Do you understand what I'm saying? Nobody kills me. Nobody. I'm the one who decides who lives and who dies. Me. You know, there's a book I read a long time ago. Still think about it every day. It helps me understand life out here. The book talks about men, about what motivates them. Simple, really. A living being seeks above all else to discharge its strength. Life itself is will to power. Nothing else matters. So long.
Bagana truck.
Better do some first aid on that. I'm Kepo and you're a problem. Who are you working with? You got some of my guys killed at the hotel, did you know that? So now I think you work for me now. Get on out here. Get yourself some gear. We got ammo and meds, weapons, whatever you need. Listen up. The shit really hit the fan back in town. There was supposed to be ceasefire, but that's all gone to hell. I work with a local guy named Kawasa. Runs muscle for the APR. I've got my best men out in the field trying to keep the UFL from encroaching on my home. Sorry, but that makes you my auxiliary. Your first duty of the day. I need you to get that rust bucket two-door outside back on the road. You know how to pick cars? Go out there and see if you can get the engine started. Stay on task. You're sick. You don't have time to screw around. Guard!
Okay, good. Now that you're mobile, let's see if you can handle something that shoots back. Your fellas got a small outpost have a click north of here. Now that the bullets are flying again, I don't want them there. Get rid of them.
one guy. Copy two guys. One guy. Just one.
You
and him.
Where the hell is he?
Come on, asshole!
Jesus, where is he? I know he's out there.
You cleared out that post. Well done. I've got another job for you. But I can't have you passing out in the middle of it. Grab some shut-eye, resupply, and be ready to go in a few hours. You'll be safe with that house. Out of the UFLL camp further north of your position, an old slaughterhouse. I want a full list of their men and their supply stores. The spot's marked on your map. Head there now. Thank you. intel. Looks good. Can you see a bricked up building there? Supposedly UFLL's got a hostage in there. Foreign national like you. You're to get in there and free him. Wrap up your survey and take care of it.
That's enough of this shit. Okay,
right? Let it rip.
This is stupid. Reloading. I need cover fire.
Pelo, you're in his sights out there. Hurry.
I know.
Yeah, tender.
God damn, let's get in there.
Hold your ground. You want to get flanked?
You're gonna die. Jesus Christ! Let's get this on! I've seen you! You ain't nothing! And I'm gonna make you a whole lot less than nothing! Come and get you, shit!
way.
You're not a guard. My God, you are sick. Malaria. I have to get out of here, but I can help you get some medicine. Come find me at Mike's bar later.
To judge you. Tell you what, anybody that does good work for me gets paid fair and square. Come on back down to the arena and we'll settle up.
Santos done. Here's the thing about the local economy. The only currency worth anything is diamonds. Forget the paper money. I wouldn't wrap a fish with it. When you work for the APR, you get paid in stones. Now, one of my men, not one of the bright ones, picked up a case of diamonds and dropped him off here yesterday. He stuck him somewhere in the camp and then went and took a bullet back in town. Maybe you killed him. Anyway, if you want those rocks, go outside and find them. The case has a tracker you can home in on with your compass. If I were you, I'd go buy some medicine next. Malaria's a big deal, man. You should head over to Mike's. It's an expat bar. Good source for all sorts of shit. Get yourself sorted out and come by the APR office in town. I'll introduce you to Kwasi. We'll talk business. It's okay. He can leave now. See you. Thank you.
Hey, it's you. How are you? You made it out. I didn't introduce myself before. My name is Flora Guillen. You still have that malaria, though, don't you? You see that man over there? He has medicine. You go ask him, he might give some to you. Take those pills, compay. You need them.
Oh, you people never stop. Here's the bloody tip, all right? That's it. That's all I've got. You're a jackboot. That's what you are. Well, aren't you going to destroy it? That's what your friends usually do. Wait, you're not here for the tips, are you? Well, I see the problem now. You can get the pills you need from the church in Pala. The priest there will help you, assuming you make it in time. Just pass it along for me.
You can't break a man the way you break a dog or a horse. The harder you beat a man, the taller.
So you're not one of them. I'm Ruben Oluwagembe, what you call a stringer. And you are new, I can tell by the state of your clothes. They're much too clean. You're taking a chance talking to me. I'm persona non grata around here. The warlords want me out of the country. They don't like the story I'm writing. It's about the war, and about them, of course. But mostly it's about the famous arms dealer, the Jaka. That was him on the tape. Do you know I have covered 16 wars across Africa? 16. And every time he has been there, selling his weapons and making a fortune while millions of people suffer and die. He thinks he can continue to do his work in secret. But not this time. These stories, they are going to come out. The Jackas, the warlords, the soldiers, the boy soldiers, even the NGOs. I intend to expose the whole sordid mess. I make it sound very dramatic. We'll see if anybody back home even notices. I've been interviewing people for months now. Diplomats, warlords, civilians, whoever I could trick into talking to me. I had some fantastic material. Then the soldiers confiscated my tapes. They said they destroyed them, but maybe not. I don't know. I can't very well go looking for them. I'm no good with a gun, you see. And you need one these days just across the street. You've seen the fighting. The war is getting worse by the minute. It's absurd. Because why are they fighting? For what? You can see the country is destroyed. The people, the diamonds, the cities. But the battle rages on with the Jaka's weapons, no less. It is going to end badly. And I'm afraid I'll be here to see it. I'm a bit of a rubbernecker, I suppose. Listen, if you find any more of my tapes, please bring them back to me, Yadaba. I need them for my story. I'll tell you right now, I can't pay you. I can only offer you my worthless friendship in return.
Right? I never forget a face. I'm Paul. You ever work with anybody? Because you know I'm fucking good. I put in my time with the Israeli Defense Force. I know how to handle myself, plus I know how to get things. Know what I mean?
hier, ek kan ons klaar speel met hom. Hou jy my vir die gek? Godverdom.
Can we finish it already? I'm moving round on his position.
Hey, hey, come here, get him.
Jeez, it don't sound like the fight's going right.
Hold your ground, you wanna get fired? I'll launch a flare. This isn't good. We need to get help.